I have a confession to make. I've been faking my chronic illness for views. Yes, all the views that I've attained over the last 9 months, all the subs, likes, the comments, all have been a manipulation of you, the viewer, so that I can get attention. Are you kidding me? Hi, I'm Ryan, and no, I'm not faking chronic illness. You see, earlier today, I got a DM asking, hey, how's the I'm sick for attention act going? Really? So I decided to respond because this comment honestly, frankly, quite literally pissed me off.
Whoa, Ryan, I'm gonna need you to calm down.
I'm angry. I'm going through a lot
okay,
right
just
now.
Calm.
I'm angry.
It's okay. No, I know you're mad.
I'm angry.
I understand. I get that you're angry.
Just breathe with me. Okay, just breathe in.
Okay. No, okay, you're right. I'll breathe. Yeah, you feel good? You feel better?
Okay, I'm good. I'm pissed. Look at my hair, I didn't even get ready for this video. That's how torqued off I am right now.
This is gonna be terrible.
This is not at all the video I wanted to make this week, but I think it's a video that needs to be made. Because this very thing is a huge problem in the chronic illness community. People who don't understand what we go through every day saying that we are just faking our pain all to get attention. Ryan, bring down your voice. Sorry. Now look, I'll be the first to admit this. I wish I was faking this. I wish that all of this was a ruse and I didn't have to wake up every day not knowing what the rest of it was going to be like for me. Would it be a day where my feet burn endlessly? Or maybe one where my calves cramp up and all I can do is sit down for the slightest bit of relief? Or you know, maybe today I'll be graced and get off lucky and my whole body will just tingle. 'Cause it never stops. Look, I'll also be the first to admit that my pain is not comparable to others. I'm honestly very lucky thus far that my pain has not gravitated to a level that I am bedridden every day, sitting in a diaper, having to poop in a bucket next to my bed because I can't walk to the toilet. My feet are too on fire. I'm fortunate. Many are not. See, the pain that I and millions of other people around the world have, in fact, is very real. That being said, there are some bad eggs. The gone bad green eggs and ham left out too long, spam in a can people who do fake illness for attention. I give you Exhibit A for asshole. About a year ago, a group of YouTubers named Extreme Gamers, whom I've actually spoken about on my other channel, a very intellectual pair, whose clickbait game took it to a whole nother level when they decided they needed to up the ante and play the I'm gonna die card on their channel. What could go wrong with that? Pretending that they're dying to get views. It's people like this who give people who are actually suffering, actually have debilitating illness, a bad name. Because when one fakes it, how can we trust all the other people? Even if it's sincere, how can you trust me? Well, luckily these two were proven false because they're really bad at lying. But you know, I think it's sad. It's sad that we live in a world where someone else can make a blind assumption with no evidence about somebody else's suffering. No facts, just hard-ass opinions. Without knowing this other person at all. I just want that moral superiority. You know, I met some amazing people in the chronic illness community. Probably some of the best people I've ever met in my entire life. Those who are brave enough to share their stories, unfiltered. Those who are kind enough to help others who are going through and just trying to figure out what the hell is wrong with them. See, what people like this commenter don't understand is that we cannot go to you to get any of that understanding. Because all we get is a response like this. Oh, it's all in your head. Oh, you're probably just stressed. Oh, you just want attention. Yes. We do want attention. We want people, and people within the medical community especially, to take us seriously. I don't know why I did that. We want to raise awareness for what illnesses like my small fiber neuropathy are really like. Because baby, they're not a walk in the park. Because if we don't speak up, if we keep it to ourselves, like a little cult club, if we just keep quiet and appear like everything is fine and dandy and whipping our hair back and forth in the wind, nothing will change for anyone. No treatments will come, no interest will be developed, no awareness will ever have been built, and people will continue to suffer and suffer until they are dead. So in a way though, I need to thank people like this commenter. Thank you, unnamed ignorance, because you gave me the opportunity to speak out, to speak the truth that we all feel. And we will be heard. Remember, I'm Ryan, and I'll keep you aware in the next video.